So today I am DIYing this hoodie. I was looking through my closet and I found it just sitting there. And I don't know if it's mine or if I've ever worn it, but it was in my closet. I honestly have no idea where this came from, but I thought, why not do a DIY on it? It already has stains on it. So obviously, like, there's a stain right here. So obviously it's been worn. I just have no idea where this came from. But it's fine because it's the perfect canvas for the DIY I have planned. My plan is I'm thinking, do a crop hoodie drawstring type thing. And then, because there are stains, I want to cover it, so I'm going to tie-dye it. I only tie-dyed 3 times in my life, so this is gonna be an experience. I'm very nervous for the tie-dye because I feel like if the tie-dye doesn't turn out well, this whole thing's gonna be a disaster. So, I guess let's get started. To start off, I'm going to take off the pocket because it's just, I want to cut right there. So to do that, I'm going to take off the pocket, I'm going to take this seam ripper. You can get it from Joann's or Michael's. I got it from my mom's sewing kit. And, you know, just take the pointy end and you take a seam and I'm bad at this. The corner, the pocket, and rip it. Just like that. So I'm going to do this whole thing. Alright, as you can see, we got this off. I'm probably going to end up cutting along this area, so I'm not going to bother doing all the seam rips. I guess now we will cut. I'd rather cut it longer than I want it to be, so I can just take off more. And I do need some extra fabric for a seam to make the drawstring. So I think we'll just kind of cut along this pocket. I did not cut this very straight. It's like, it like dips. It's fine. We'll make it work. Alright, so I have it cut. I definitely cut it a lot longer than what I want it to be, but that's perfectly fine because what we're going to do is we're going to fold it to the length I want, and then we're going to pin the fabric. I'm going to make sure this is straight, and then I'm going to take a sewing machine and I'm going to sew a line, and then we'll kind of have a little hem to put our drawstring in.
As you can see here, I pinned my sweatshirt and I marked where I will be sewing the line. I left about 1/2 inch for where my hem's going to be, and now it's all sewn and looks good. We are going to cut off the extra fabric because it's kind of pointless and will just get in the way, but do keep the extra fabric because we will be using it later for something. And then voila, here we have the finished look. It's actually straight. I took a very long time making sure it was straight. And remember that extra fabric? We are going to keep that and use it for our drawstring around the waist. Now it's time to get tie-dyeing. We're going to take out all the strings because we'll tie-dye those separately. I'm going for a marble look, so I'm not actually going to use any tie-dyeing pattern. I'm just going to bunch together the different limbs and secure it with rubber bands and then bunch it all together into one big ball. I highly suggest when you're tie-dyeing putting something down to tie-dye on so you don't get tie-dye everywhere. Also put on a shirt you're okay with getting dirty, because like I said, tie-dye will actually probably go everywhere. But here we have our wad of cloth now, and it doesn't even look like a sweatshirt, but it is time to get tie-dyeing. I got my tie-dye from Joann's, and the powder's already in there. We just fill it up with water to activate the dye and shake like crazy so it's all well mixed. Now we're going to put on our gloves and just go crazy putting tie-dye everywhere. I ran out of tie-dye And as you just saw, it's not as blue as I want it to be. I really want it to be extremely blue, like as in mostly blue, not much white. So we're running to Michael's to get more. And I think I might grab a McDonald's while I'm there. Yep. Fun times. We are at Michael's. We found tie-dye.
Alright, so I am parked at the moment as I film this. I just wanted to say, I got hungry and my mom informed me we're having a late dinner. So I thought, McDonald's is right here by Michael's. Might as well get some. So as I'm ordering, I kind of panicked. Wasn't sure what to get. I couldn't read the menu because I don't have my contacts in. So I'm like, I'll get chicken nuggets. And they immediately assumed I wanted a Happy Meal. And I just didn't want to say anything. So yes, I have a Happy Meal now. We're going to go with it. But that's not even the best part. I got a toy. I got Beast Boy from Teen Titans. So that's fun. But it's okay because I got fries and nuggets now to eat. So it's a little appetizer for dinner.
And we are back to tie-dyeing. I did eat my McDonald's. It was very delicious. But anyways, we are putting our tie-dye everywhere. I'm making sure I put it in the crevices too, just so I have tie-dye everywhere. For our drawstring, I put that in my hand, squirted some tie-dye in my hand, and just smushed it around. But now we have this cloth of blueberry goodness, and it's very satisfying to look at. Now we're going to take some saran wrap and wrap it around our sweatshirt. It helps hold in the moisture overnight as we let it sit, so the tie-dye gets real effect. Once the sweatshirt is all wrapped up in saran wrap, we are just going to throw it in a plastic bag to leave to sit.
Alright, so the sweatshirt is currently sitting in this bag, marinating, and we're just going to let it marinate overnight, so we'll get back to it tomorrow, and hopefully it looks good, or I'm going to be sad. Alright, so it's the next day, and we're ready to check out the tie-dye, and I'm very scared because I realized at about 10 o'clock at night yesterday that you're supposed to wet the cloth before you put the dye on, which I didn't do, so that's probably why I needed 3 packs of tie-dye because it wasn't sinking in. So I'm very scared now to see how this turned out.
Now we're just going to take our scissors and cut off the rubber bands because it's so much easier than trying to untangle it. And oh my god, you guys, this actually turned out good and I'm so happy. I freaked out over nothing. But we do have to wash out the extra tie-dye, so we're just going to keep rinsing it in the sink until the water turns clear and is not tinted blue anymore. Once that happens, we are going to throw it in the wash. And I put a little bit of detergent in it, and we're pretty much going to put it in and pray that all the tie-dye does not wash out.
All right, moment of truth. It just got out of the dryer. Okay, so we have our strings. Ooh. Turned out pretty nice. I'm so excited. Okay, we are going to go put the strings in, and then it'll be the completed look.
For our drawstring, we have to create notches in the fabric hem that we made. So I'm going to take my pencil and mark where I want those notches to be. I put a shoelace down the center of the sweatshirt just so I knew where the center was. Now we're taking our scissors and we're going to cut on those lines we just made. Careful to cut just the top layer of the fabric because we don't want to cut all the way through. Now to feed the string through our sweatshirt, we're actually going to take a safety pin and connect it to the end of the fabric, because it's just easier to feed it through the fabric that way because you can feel the safety pin. And then after that, we'll have our completed look.
What's up, my people? So, fun fact, I'm filming this outro, final word, whatever it's called, almost 3 months after I originally made the sweatshirt. I'm great. I'm not procrastinating, I swear. I started editing the video, then it all got deleted, then I just didn't want to re-edit it, so here we are. But as you can see, the sweatshirt turned out so nice. I love it. I have actually been wearing it these past 3 months, so it's kind of a good thing. I took forever to edit it. Not really. But I've worn it out and about. I've actually gotten compliments on it. It's so cute and comfy. And I think overall this was pretty successful DIY. Sort of. But yeah. That's it. Hope you guys enjoyed the video.